Imagine a football team with 20 players. During its first season, 10 players wear helmets on the field and 10 do not. And at the end of the season, two of the helmeted players have had head injuries. So have six of the unhelmeted players.
I think that's a great example.
Researcher Sam Scarpino with the Rockefeller Institute and Northeastern University says, now imagine that next season the coach has all 20 players wear helmets. Four of them still get head injuries. Since helmeted injuries went up from 2 to 4, did helmet effectiveness go down? Of course not, says Scarpino.
Actually, the total number of injuries went down as a result, even though the helmeted number went up when you got helmets on everybody.
In our example, total injuries dropped to 4 compared to 8 when half of the team was unhelmeted. It's a common statistical trap called the base rate fallacy. And Scarpino says people are making the same mistake when looking at breakthrough COVID cases among vaccinated people. They're focusing too much on the fact that since early July, breakthrough cases in Massachusetts have risen by a factor of 5.
But the total number of cases across the whole state is actually up by 10x since July. And so we actually have a slower rate of growth in the percent of these breakthrough infections as compared to the overall cases.
What's more, Scarpino says helmets, like vaccines, offer an additional layer of protection.
These individuals are much more likely to have mild injuries as compared to a much more severe injury that would occur in an unhelmeted setting.